Do you have strange people floating around in your family tree? Are you having trouble finding them on Ancestry and getting rid of them? If you have a family tree with more than a few hundred people in it, chances are you have unconnected twigs and branches that you might want to remove, but you're not sure how. Howdy, my name is Devin Noel Lee, and I love helping people climb their family tree and enjoy the journey of connecting to the past. Ancestry.com is a great resource for doing just that. However, if you don't take time to clean up your family tree, you could create a mess for yourself and others. A viewer named Ed McFannin from Oregon sent in this email. I have recently had several contacts with people who have accidentally created floating tree branches on their family tree. They do not even know what a floating tree is or how it even got there. Several have even gotten angry with me, thinking I'm some kind of scammer when I have told them that they have hidden profiles. Oh dear, Ed. Before we continue, let's define a specific term. A floating tree is like a family tree within a family tree, meaning you have a cluster of people that are not connected to anyone else in your family tree. While Connie Knox from Genealogy TV says the primary purpose of a floating tree is to trace other clans that somehow are associated with your ancestors, there are times when people are in our family trees by mistake. Ed continues, in checking for tutorials, I found many that explain how to intentionally create a floating tree. I found no tutorials on how to properly remove a mistaken branch so it does not create a hidden floating tree. Ed is correct. There are no tutorials on deleting floating trees online until now. Ancestry offers no easy way to find disconnected family branches and twigs in your overall family tree. You will need to download your family tree to a genealogy software program. The two I am most familiar with are Family Tree Maker and RootsMagic. After downloading your family tree from Ancestry to Family Tree Maker, there are two ways to find unattached individuals or floating trees. The first involves running a data error report. Open a family tree, navigate to the home person in your family tree, click Publish. Choose Person Reports, choose Data Errors Report, click Create a Report. Ensure all individuals is selected. Click on this first icon below the menu title of Data Errors Report option. In the Errors to Include screen, check Exclude All. Then check the box beside the person errors that said person is unattached. Family Tree Maker will then show you a list of unattached persons in your family tree. You can either delete this person in Family Tree Maker and then seek your tree to Ancestry, or you can delete the person from Ancestry manually and sync your family tree file later. The second option is to create a relationships report. Open a family tree, navigate to the home person in your family tree, click Publish, choose Relationship Reports, choose Kinship Report, click Create Report. Select the All Individuals option, then check the boxes for Show Unrelated Individuals, Sort Individuals by Kinship, click Generate Report. Scroll down the report looking at the Kinship section until you see Unrelated. You can now proceed to delete these names similarly to what I shared before. Be very careful when deleting names on these lists. While you might not be directly related to these persons, they may be indirect kin or clues you want to keep because they help you break through brick walls. For instance, Magdalena is the second wife of a man who traveled to the US from Hanover with my ancestors. Descendants of that family married into my family later. But also, I believe they're connected in the home country. I just haven't proven that yet. Having this person in my tree reminds me of that specific research person. In short, I don't want to delete Magdalena from this tree, even though she's unrelated. Roots Magic has an easy button to find floating trees in their program. In fact, it only has three steps. First, you need to download your Ancestry family tree into Roots Magic if you haven't already done that. That's a step that doesn't really count. Then do these three things. Open a family tree file. On the People tab, click the wrench and screwdriver icon in the top right menu area. Choose the Count Trees option. Roots Magic will show you how many floating trees you have on Ancestry. Then you can decide what to do with them. Look how easy and complete that is. Once you have found your floating trees on Ancestry using genealogy software in determining which ones you do not need, how do you remove them? Ancestry says to prevent accidental deletions, it's not possible to delete an entire branch of a tree at once. This is a great policy because you can really mess up a large tree if you rapidly delete multiple people. Let's review how to delete a person on Ancestry one at a time. Navigate to the person you want to delete. Click on Edit. Click on Delete Person. Confirm you want to delete the person. When the person is deleted, Ancestry will take you to the next logically available profile. The next likely profile could be a parent, spouse, or child. Since deleting a floating tree can be challenging, follow these additional steps. Start with the profile at the bottom of a tree and work your way to the top. Be careful to make note of any tangent branches you will need to remove later. In this example, the bottom of the tree is Thomas Petty, but you want to ensure you delete his siblings who are also on this lower level. In this case, I have a stepbrother. Since Thomas's brother has a wife, you will need to delete her profile first. If they had children, you would delete their children first, and then delete the wife, and then delete the stepbrother. After deleting the wife, Ancestry brings you back to Thomas's brother Bruce's profile. Now you can delete him. If you delete from the tree view, you will be brought back to Thomas. You can delete him here. Unfortunately, in this view, you can't climb your tree to delete. You need to navigate back to Thomas's father using tree search. Click into Earl's profile. Proceed to delete the floating tree person from here. The delete person is accessed from the Edit tab in the upper right corner. Continue working your way up the unlinked family tree in this fashion. When you're working with Family Tree Maker, sync your family tree with Ancestry when you open the software, and these persons should disappear from that program. The advantage of deleting a person using Roots Magic, even though it requires a few more steps, is that you can ensure you are completely deleting floating trees by constantly running the Count Trees tool. Use the Count Trees tool mentioned earlier to access the floating tree. Click on the Descendants view. Use the arrows to expand the floating tree to the top generation. Right-click on a person you want to delete. Choose the Delete option. You can then choose Delete the person or Delete the family. This is the only rapid deletion tool, but it only impacts the Roots Magic database. Either one will work, so choose Delete family when you can. Just be careful when you're doing this so as not to mess up your family tree. When finished, run the Count Trees tool again to confirm you have deleted unwanted floating trees. Once you have removed the unwanted, unlinked trees, compare your Roots Magic tree to Ancestry using the Tree Share tool. Search for one of the names from the floating tree. Notice that the Roots Magic panel is blank, but the Ancestry panel has a profile. Choose the Delete button. Confirm your decision to delete that profile. Ancestry will then run a syncing and deleting process. Continue working through the tree share tool to find persons that were in the unlinked tree that should be removed. Ed, I hope that answers your question. Thanks for sending it in. If you have a question about Ancestry, Family Search, MyHeritage that you would like answered, send it in using the contact form on our website. The link will be in the description box. If you're ready for another tutorial on how to use Ancestry, check out this video right here.